So, we're back. The last video for Monkey Island 2.
Bonus features.
Yeah, bonus features. Let's see.
And commentary.
So, we will not see the commentary because that means we have to play the whole game again. And oh my god, no way. I'm not playing
this.
Oh,
you play the game and there's the developer's commentary?
Yeah, I guess in every screen they start.
No.
But we unlocked some concept art.
Yes, I want to see the concept art. I love concept art. Oh my god, look at it. It's watercolor.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's got my love.
So it's got dates.
92.
But did we say this game came out in
91? It's 92, actually.
That's crazy. Then this game came out in 93. Is Wikipedia wrong? I don't believe it. Something else keeps...
Yeah, it was summer.
Oh,
Elaine!
Oh, this is the old one.
The old version.
This is the concept art of the remake.
For the new, yes. The new one.
So it did so many iterations, you see?
Yep.
Until they chose one of it. I think they chose that one? No, that one.
I don't even remember. I mean, they're all quite similar.
Yes, but it doesn't look anything like the old one.
No,
but
it does. I mean, look at it. All the elements are there. The trousers, the
blonde boots.
She's
blonde.
Oh, she's not blonde in the next game. No, she's not blonde here either. She's never blonde.
Oh, here the Largo.
She's brown-haired.
Largo.
Yes. Scalp Island. Largo again.
Oh my god, so many. I don't know if I have to pick these artists or admire them. I mean, they have to draw so many times the same thing with different ideas.
I think this one
so
is.
So that some manager can say, oh, I like this one.
Guybrush! Oh, they did intend to have him have a mustache.
Because I'm not
a mustache,
I'm not an artist. I cannot even see the difference in some photos.
I do.
I know you're an artist. I know, but I Monkey Island.
They made him look a bit older here.
So this
they tried at least.
Original version 3, it says there.
Mm-hmm. They tried to make him look older.
Mm.
And now he's back at being a. Youngster.
Designed by Steve Purcell, the cartographer, 92.
July.
Artist Purcell. Oh, hand-drawn stuff.
Oh, Wally!
Yeah, original. Oh, they almost did him like a child. Look at the bottom left.
Yep. That's how they did him, eventually.
No, I don't think they picked this one.
They picked one of those. They picked one of the last ones.
Okay, that's quite faithful. Oh,
the voodoo place.
The voodoo
lady.
So look, it used to have a dog, but then they scrapped it. They
and
made
they used
the mouth. It,
the mouth.
So they did this one.
The lady that is
voodoo
sitting
lady.
There. And, yeah, it's so. The slippers killed me.
Steve Purcell again.
Yep. The cemetery.
March 92. Cemetery of Scab Island with one B.
And. What was that? Something again from Scab Island.
Yes, we went there, but not for months. We don't...
Ah, that's where we found our navigator.
Oh, yeah. They have two versions.
Mm.
Oh, cool. This was from Big Time. I remember this guy from the Full Throttle art.
Yeah.
He did almost everything.
LeChuck. LeChuck is so cool.
Mm-hmm.
The Office.
I think they changed that a little bit, right?
Just a little bit. Let's check again with color.
But without eyes, just the basic.
Ooh!
Voodoo priest? Ah, yes, it was in one scene, just. Yeah. And then never seen again.
Mm-hmm.
The detail from the environment.
More details. Ship.
This was used verbatim. It's like the final thing.
Yep.
They just put a steering wheel here and then.
And Fatah. Oh, that guard.
Oh, they even had an Aladdin version. Look, version 6. I like version 4. So they used version 2 in the end. Mm
hmm.
Ship. Mad Marty.
Yeah, Marty. From Skab Island.
Mm-hmm. The Fat Island Panorama. That's very nice.
Mm-hmm.
The carpet post.
Oh, that dude. Oh my god.
Who is he?
Ah, the guy that.
The dealer,
yeah.
Oh, yeah, that has the spinning wheel.
The guy that cheats. The door, yeah.
Oh, you found this riddle. If you hadn't guessed it, oh my god.
The mansion looks cool. The colors are amazing.
This is just like it was in the game.
Yeah,
just
but look at that. The colors are more vibrant than the game. The
librarian. So how did they go from this to the last one that they used? Oh.
Look at all the rest.
The previous one with all the rolls. Oh my god.
That would have been amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the
fisherman. Booty Island. The booty. So you
bought. Look at the colors. He's sampling the colors with markers. So it's marker.
So it's like which colors he used or something?
Yep. These are the colors he's sampling.
Oh my god. Tick dealer.
Yep.
So.
The version 3.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he used. Oh, yes.
The one who fires the cannon. Has a name. Oh, more color sampling.
Yep.
So what? Like every time an artist draws something, he puts the color on the side so that he remembers the palette?
First is to remember the palette, and second is to check the marker and check how it works. So he will have a good blending.
Hmm, I see. Shopkeeper.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm? Ah, the Winnie hat? Ah, no. Ah, it's where you... But you were there by day, not by night. Where they stopped you to open the... to go to the mansion.
I see, yes.
Stand shop?
Yeah.
Gardener.
The dog.
The hound. The old hound. Gary Chu. Gary Chu from... Pete Chan from 91. Back of the mansion. And you see special...
Special editions.
How the door open will be and how the trash can...
The kitchen.
Yeah. How many are there?
A lot of them. Guybrush's mom.
Mm-hmm.
Aww.
Guybrush's dad.
Yeah, I mean...
They gave him a belly. Why did they give him a beer belly? He used to be like version 5 in the original.
The skeletons.
Oh. I don't know what it is, but this is nice.
This looks like...
Like a sketch pad.
Elaine.
It is Elaine. It says here, Elaine Marley, but...
It's various versions of Elaine.
Mm-hmm. The cliffs.
The guy with the speed contest.
Yeah, the speedmaster. Cool, sketchy.
Yep. Oh, the old pirate.
The Captain Ram.
Captain Ram.
Yeah, when you go down with the frames, LeChuck's head for some reason.
LeChuck.
What is this?
This looks like LeChuck's office.
Maybe. A door. One of the doors, LeChuck's dog. Oh, the final LeChuck.
Okay, look at that. The one on the right. Look at it. It's the third model. It's one they used, I guess, on the next Monkey Island.
Yeah, this is on the fourth one, I think. The yellow bird, the flaming. Yep. The fourth one. I think they use it as a reference to make the one in the second that matches the body.
Probably.
Ah, it says what everything is. Skull. It's because the original was different, you see?
Yeah,
a little bit different.
He was just a pirate zombie.
Herman Toothroat.
Oh,
a shipwreck on every island. And this is what?
Oh, that's the place, the last place we were. The last place. Yeah, it's a concept art for the last place we were.
Oh, this looks nothing like the final one.
Yeah, it's different. It's a lot different.
And this is the end. So, let's talk about... Oh, there are some courses that we haven't unlocked. Also, we unlocked everything except the four last ones. What do we have to do?
I don't know.
Anyway. So, let's talk about the games. The first two games. Let's talk about.
Okay.
So, who will start?
You will start.
Okay. So, I will tell you what I did. We haven't saved. Oh my god. So, in the end, we did not save in the end. Our last save is like, oh, so many. Okay, so. I just saw the load now and I remember we did not save.
Go on!
Yeah. So, I did not like the art of the remake of the first game.
Why?
They changed too many things. While in this game, everything looked like more beautiful, more polished, but the same. In the first game, in the remastered version, there were many characters which were just different feel.
Yeah,
the feel was different.
But if you check the character,
let me finish, please.
Okay.
In this game, the feel was the same. The colors were the same. The effects were. They just made everything more polished.
Mm-hmm.
In the first game, they completely redid it. I don't like it.
Okay.
That's about the remakes and the art. Now about the game. The second game was much more complicated. I really don't know how they just went from zero to hero. They make suddenly there are three islands and there are riddles that you have puzzles. You have to go to all islands to solve, take an object for one, travel to the other, do this, this.
Imagine it in real life.
Yes, I imagine the people writing it like, oh my god, yeah, the first one was too easy, let's make something more difficult, let's make like three islands and people have to travel all over and... No, please.
Let's just say that if there was a pirate that would go to all these islands, then the quest for Big Whoop would not be a few hours. Or it would be a few years.
But anyway, the riddles were more crazy. They were more out of this world riddles in this game. In the first game, I think we solved almost everything ourselves. In this game, we have to do the hint system so many times because the hint system told us to inflate the gloves and we did not do anything with the gloves.
Maybe that's why we didn't have the concept art.
But I don't know, it was some optional...
Something to do with LeChuck. Probably we could have done
anyway,
something.
I loved the hint system. It's very good because these games were crazy.
Yeah, it helps a lot.
And I really think that why they put this riddle back then was because they wanted to sell hint lines and guides. Because back then we were all buying guides with the solution of the game.
I remember that.
When they were not in the magazines, because the gaming magazines also had columns where you sent letters, not emails, like letters.
Yeah,
the magazine.
I know, I remember.
And maybe 3 months later, on some issue,
they had a gamer that
yeah.
would have the whole walkthrough.
Yeah,
they would have it either in parts or.
Yeah, 3 months later, you might see your letter and the reply to the riddle you were stuck. But oh my god,
yeah.
I mean, The riddles were some puzzles in this game. They were absolutely unquestionably bad. Where like? There is no clue. Many. I don't remember like the final one with LeChuck.
Yeah.
I mean, there were many puzzles where there were the handkerchief one.
Yeah. How
Why would
know?
You give him a handkerchief? They could have him sneeze, for example, so they give you a clue. But no,
True.
It was just bad. And I think they did it on purpose back then to sell more solutions.
True.
Otherwise, I had very much fun. I laughed a lot, especially in the first game. In the second too, but I don't know, the first one was more, the humor was more to my like. Okay, so now your turn. That was what everything I had to say.
Well, I found the games interesting. So many LucasArts references.
Yeah, of course, because it was made by LucasArts.
Yeah, but it was, I don't know, it's just like, buy the game, buy the movies. You know, it's a big advertisement. It's a big advertisement.
I'm your brother, Guy Brass. Take off my mask before I die. No.
Search your feelings, you know it to be true. I loved the art. And I loved the first
original
game.
Yeah.
I loved the remake art.
You didn't like the pixelated original super art.
At the first game, the pixelated was was very bad.
I can't
because that's how pixelated art was. You couldn't make out the pixels. The second game was
actually
a lot better.
It was worse resolution, I think. It should be like
true.
The first game should be VGA and the second should be Super VGA or something.
The thing is that the first game had very bad graphics because that's how graphics were. I mean, I saw the first Prince of Persia once and I realized that it looks nothing like Prince of Persia. And then I saw plenty of remakes and then it looked like Prince of Persia.
Prince of Persia 2 was much better.
Exactly, and Monkey Island 2 was much better.
Okay, other than the art, how about the gameplay?
Well, the gameplay was a simple adventure gameplay, as I remember it from every game that I've played so far. And the riddles are... Well... They don't always not make sense. Sometimes they do make sense. It does make sense.
And sometimes they make sense after you solve them by accident.
And then you say, oh.
Yes, oh yes, that was... Anyway, I know that was how the games were back then. I mean, we will play Simon the Sorcerer. I think we'll play them with a guide because Simon the Sorcerer was known for its crazy nonsense riddles and...
And I don't understand sometimes the humor. I understand the humor, but they could at least not put on. They could at least connect better with the riddles. I mean, they had humor, but they had it for the sake of humor.
Both games now, or
both games? No! The first game had humorous riddles. The second did not. The second had humorous dialogue.
Yeah.
But not so much humorous riddles.
True. Plus they gave us circus tickets and there were no fettuccine brothers.
Yes, where were the fettuccine brothers?
I protest. Where they were cut somewhere or we just didn't find them and we did not unlock concept art. I don't know. I have no idea.
Yeah. But I liked it. It was nice and a good adventure.
So, see you on the third game. Bye.